my favorite comedians just came from across the pond. Did you take a loop, a lift? Something like that. Anyway, give it up for Jay McFall, everybody. Big round of applause, Jay McFall. Yeah.
What's up? How y'all doing tonight? Y'all having a good time? Oh man, I'm not gonna lie to y'all. I was late coming here. I missed my Uber. It was all bad. I know. Ooh, a black guy being late. Surprise! No. It's bad. Like, I'm a traditionally late person, habitually late, and I've been trying to be more responsible about it. So I've been trying to text people when I'm gonna be late, let them know ahead of time. But it's getting to the point where I might have a problem. Realizing I might have a problem because I texted one of my friends the other day. We were supposed to meet up. I texted her. I was like, "Hey, I'm gonna be like 20 minutes late," and she just texted back, "I know." Dang, you can lie to me or something, you know? Making me feel bad. That was funny, man. I was having this conversation with my mom the other day. I recently deleted Tinder because I felt like it was giving my mom too much hope that there was someone out there for me. You know, just a chance of grandkids. She's like, "Oh, they coming?" No, no, Jamila, they're not coming. And it's funny, I can't really do Tinder because I read the profiles. I used to read the profiles all the time, and it was always the same thing. It's always a picture of three girls. It's never the one you want, it's the one on the end. You know? She's the one with her leg up like this. She's like, "Oh my God, Texas X16, cat mom, your mom's new favorite girlfriend." Two things about that. First off, you don't know my mom. Can you keep Jamila's name out your mouth? Secondly, you're not a cat mom, you're a cat owner. There's a difference. Cat mom means it's your son, you're its mom, you love it, it loves you. Parent-son relationship. Cat owner means you own it, you love it, like to pretend it loves you. Slave-slave owner relationship. You're a Thomas Jefferson, Sally Johnson thing. It's a deep cut, I'm so proud y'all got that. And like, here's the thing, I'm not a cat person at all, I don't like cats, but every time I meet cat people, they always try to convince me I just haven't met the right cat. No, it's like, "Oh, you don't like cats? But you haven't met my cat. My cat is special. Just love it." They try to put it in your face. You're like, like, "Oh, my cat." They sound like a frat boy trying to convince a lesbian that she's secretly straight and she just doesn't know. "But you haven't tried anything. How would you know?" Oh, man. If you couldn't tell, I'm black. Surprise. And I have a lot of white friends, and sometimes I have to explain things to my white friends. Like the other day, I had to explain white privilege, which stick with me here. Because the way I did it, listen, white privilege, the way I explained it was by bringing up Home Alone, the 1990s Macaulay Culkin movie, and the subsequent 1992 sequel, you know? Because white privilege truly is Kevin McAllister's mom losing him 2 years in a row consecutively, and never once having Child Protective Services called on her. She lost him in 1990 Chicago and 92 Brooklyn. It was crazy. All right, y'all have been great. My name is Jay McFall.